Hiya, kids. We're shaking here in St. Louis. It's great to be back here. We're going to continue on with a tune from our album from the mid-70s that was called Asia. Thank you. Up on the hill, people never stand. They just don't care.
Chinese music on the banyan trees. Here at the
on the hill. They think I'm okay, or so they say.
Chinese music always sets me free. Angular banjos sound good to me. Asia, when all my bad dancing is through, I run to you.
Asia, that featured on guitar John Harrington, and on tenor sax Walt Weisskopf, and on drums Keith Carlock.
Nothing in common.
So right before the show, our trumpet player, Mr. Michael Lenhart, and our trombone player, Mr. Jim Pugh, got into a terrible argument. So I thought it'd be a good idea if they aired it out in public. Let the people decide. Now, Michael. Michael, tell the audience what you were trying to tell Jim backstage when you were causing back a ruckus back there. We couldn't even, you know, get ready for the show because you were trying to, you know, tell him exactly what you were. Uh-huh. I see. Uh-huh. Oh, brother. Uh-huh. Well, I didn't know you felt like that, Mike. Now, Jim, state to Michael exactly what your reply was backstage when the shouting started and all that. And we couldn't, you know, even... your risers. I don't want to hear another word. Well, maybe they'll straighten it out after the show over a shot of tequila. You know, the kind I'm talking about, the kind you got to go down to Mexico to get, or you used to. Now they have it right here. Ladies, what's the name of that tequila? You know, Gorvo, Baron Corvo, no, it's, yeah, that's it. Jose Cuervo, it was something like that. Man.
Make tonight a wonderful thing. The Cuervo Gold, the fine Colombian. Make tonight a wonderful thing.
Say it again.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mr. Michael Linhart on trumpet and Mr. Jim Pugh on the trombone. Thank you. How you doing so far out there? Yeah, that's what I like to hear. It's kind of hot and humid, but I don't know. I'm bugging out actually right up here. I don't know what's going on. Man. Screamer, know how to hide. you.
Thank you.
home at last. Thank you. Thank you. What a night! I'm bugging out! A little more blues here, settle in for a second. gonna change the tone, change the texture of the night, change the texture of the very night.
Yeah.
Whitney. And we heard from a baritone saxophone player named Roger Rosenberg. We heard from Walt Weisskopf on tenor. We heard from Michael Linhart on the trumpet, from Jim Pugh on the trombone, and from John Harrington on the guitar. Thank you. Here's a tune from an album that was called The Royal Scam, called Green Earrings.
Daring
Thank you. Gentlemen, would you like to tune your guitars? Oh, that was fun. It was just like we were playing folk music or something. Nice. Okay. Right now, our lovely vocalists are going to do a tune for you. Our lovely vocalists, Miss Cindy and Miss Carolyn, our ladies of the Citronella Candles. They're going to sing a song from our very first album called Dirty Work.
Oh, yeah. I don't want
Thank you, girls. That was very lovely. You're a cute bunch. I don't know, it's something about you. Just like you. I don't know. Well, that beautiful song made me put me in the mood for a little funk. What do you say? Yeah, that kind of thing. Makes me feel good. Now, you have a little funk, you need a little funky break. Funky break, sort of like this.
It's Labor Day. I guess that means the summer is mostly kind of winding down at this point. And as you may know, this is the last night of our tour this summer. And I just want to tell you all how pleased and privileged we are to be here with you tonight in St. Louis. Yeah. We had a great time touring this summer with these guys in this band, and instead of the usual funny business tonight, I'm just going to tell you who they are and let you welcome them and reward them with your applause, and also we'll be doing the same things in our hearts because they've just played so great for us all summer. Our lead guitarist, John Harrington. On the baritone saxophone, Roger Rosenberg. On the alto and tenor saxophones, Walt Weisskopf. And the trumpet, Michael Lenhart. And on the trombone, Jim Pugh. Let's have a little drum breakdown just for a minute so I can demonstrate something. Let's have a round of applause for the heartbeat of our band, Mr. Keith Carlock. And a little bass now. The other half of that heartbeat, Mr. Freddie Washington. Piano, Mr. Jeff Young. Our female vocalist, please welcome Miss Carolyn Lenhart Escoffrey. And the ever luscious Cindy Mizell. I can honestly say that this is the best band of musicians I've ever had the privilege of playing with, and I want to thank them all again. And in particular, I think what made this summer so special for us was touring with this other musician that we're going to bring out in a minute. But first, let me tell you about our Fender Rhodes piano player, our lead vocalist, singer, songwriter extraordinaire, traveler, author, raconteur. Please welcome, if you will, the Fab Original One, the original, the originator, Mr. Donald Fagen. Truly, Walter Becker. Now, it's been our tradition every summer, about this time in the summer, to award a very special prize that we have here. It's called the Bunsen Prize. And no surprise to anybody that this year's winner is a great musician, a great human being, native son of St. Louis, Missouri. Please welcome back on stage, if you will, the 2006 Bunsen Prize winner, Mr. Mike McDonald. Mr. Mike McDonald.
We're having us out this summer. It's a great place to wind up for us here in St. Louis, Missouri. And on behalf of my band and crew, I want to thank all the management and all these guys up here. What a fabulous band. What do you say? Check the supreme.
Blake. Showbiz Kids, thank you. You know, back in by my congratulations on that Bunsen prize there.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah. So back in around 1973, we were looking for a singer who could sing high parts, you know, background parts, and our drummer at the time said, "Hey, I just made a demo down the street with this guy. You should audition him." So the next day, Mike came over. He could play keyboards too, and we took him on the road. And the problem was he was a little too good, and I thought maybe I was in danger of losing my position. And so we had to kick him upstairs to the Doobie Brothers. But for a year, it was great. We went on the road, and we used to have him sing some leads. He was so good, like this one right here. This is the way we did it in 1974.
all it's good I know. When you smile for the camera, well, I love you better. Hey,
hey, come back to me. Hey, come back to me.
Well,
set up shots.
You see it all 3D.
Not in the mood for that one tonight.
Get a lock, get Charlemagne. Get a lock, get Charlemagne.
Thank you. you. Good night.
What a fantastic crowd to end our summer with. Thank you so much for coming. Give yourselves a big hand. And there's a couple other people I want to thank, too. I want to thank Phil Jones and from PJB and all of his friends for coming down here tonight. And I want to thank the people that have been supporting us all summer and made this so much fun for us, our crew members, including but not limited to Mo Hagedorn, Lucy Krause, John Pollock, our lighting guy, John Robbins, our front of house mixer, Dave Staub on monitors, Albert Bermudez, Jack Dietering, Skip Gildersleeve. Come on out here, guys. Let's have everybody out here. Lauren Wheaton, all the way from Canada. Marty Kellerer, our keyboard tech. Kevin Campbell, Joe Dougherty, Courtney Berger, Chris McKell, Derek Brannon, Robert Smith, PJ Reynolds, John Laughlin, Bob Bramell, Mike, Agent 99, truck driver, James Inman, Steve Lewis. And especially I want to thank, again, Mike McDonald and all of the members of Mike's band and crew that made this such a groove for us. Thank you.
Can we go home tomorrow? Can we go home now? I got two more tunes. All right. Thank you. We got time for one more. Thank you. Thanks for coming. I hope you liked our music. See you next time. Drive carefully.